Thank you, Hoches. Hi, I am Yoichi Ochai from the University of Tsukuba. I'm currently assistant professor of the University of Tsukuba and also the head of the Digital Nature Group. And today I'd like to talk of the holographic whisper. This speaker can generate the audible focus in the air in the orbital 3D positions. And let me start. And also I'd like to start from the conceptual things. So we envision the post-pixel worlds. So how can we make like a 2D or 2.2D physical device? And also, how can we release the data form towards a 3D space? Like how to use the computational wave design or making a magical experience with no contact device. So we focus on these interactions. We have a key that is the outer range of the frequency of our sensory organs. And also, like a traditional scenery of the Yuhitas century, like this. Like these are physical laptops, and also the pixel images, and the 2.5 devices, and also 2.5 boxes like mug cups, and also the sound and the haptics. So this scenery is looked in the 2000s, 2020s. And also, previous contribution, we are focused on how to generate these three-dimensional image, like making the plasma, or making the audible fields, or making the haptics in the air, or how to manipulate the object by the computational synthesis. So then came up an idea. Then, next, how can we make the holographic
audio? Whisper. We employ an ultrasonic phased array as a holographic acoustic generator to focus ultrasound at arbitrary three-dimensional positions. This sound point method enables us to control aerial audio distributions more flexibly and more precisely in comparison with conventional super-directional loudspeakers. These point sound sources can deliver private messages or music to individuals. This suggests various application combined with conventional interaction methods.
Oh, better the English than me. Our contribution is towards the three-dimensional audio communication. We make the holographic points and the steerable beams to generate the sound in the three-dimensional space. So here is the overview. Here is the overview. The conventional super-directional speaker makes the beams. However, our speaker makes the focus around the users to generate the sound. And so, the point is designing the narrow audio distribution for the individual communication to say something to the individual users and to another. So our contribution is the method enables the production of the ARL sound point sources, and also our paper included the principles, the simulated results, user study, applications, theories, implementation, evaluation, and discussion, and so quite a lot. So let me start from the related works. So the audio communication is separated from the Edison's age, like individual communication using the headphones, and also the broad communication using the speakers. And many efforts for the audible representation, like 19th to the 21st century, like broad speakers, or space surrounding audio, like 5.1 channel speakers, or individual headphones. Then our focus is different from that. Efforts. We are focusing on the 3D points and the steerable beams. So, to the efforts towards the holographic individual audio, like there is two kind of the speakers, like making the audible sounds and also the ultrasonic sounds. And also we categorized like a single channel and also phased array. That means a single channel makes a single speaker, single frequency, and the audio. Also using the phased array as a multiple controller for the each speakers. So we pick up for these ultrasound speakers to explain in here. And then, can I ask about questions? And do you know how the ultrasonic directional audio works? How many people know the function of ultrasonic beams? One or two or three? Okay, got it. So let me start from this side. So the top side is conventional ultrasonic loudspeakers, and also it makes a beam in the three-dimensional space. This is a transducers, so it makes like a spherical waves from each speakers. So the wave front is like this shape. So it is a plane waves. So it can make the sound beams like this. And this is a beam. So also some of you were around in the university, like it is like a laser or laser optics. It is a quite similar things. And also, how does it make the audible sound? It is a self-demodulation effect generates audible sounds. So it, in the sound beams, we can hear the audible sound lower than the ultrasonic frequency. So that means that in beams, you can hear the audible sound from the amplitude modulation or frequency modulations. So there are many efforts, like beamforming to point audio, so like this. So it makes audible area by using the many phased arrays. And also there is some effort to making a steering beams to make the wavefront like this, and also make the beam like this way. And so our contribution is making the focal point of the sound like this. Then wavefront is this shape, like a spherical waves. So it generates sound focus here. So it is quite similar things like laser and also plasma at the focal point of the objective lens. So it makes sound focus there. So the focusing techniques of the ultrasonic phased array is well matured in HCI communities, such like making the haptics by the ultrasound and also generating the haptic focus or haptic feedback by in the air by ultrasonic is currently studied for the many researchers. And yeah, so my keyboard doesn't work. Yes. Oh no. Oh, sorry. Oh, oops. So here is a video that works, that shows how it works. Like this, we can change the position of the sound focus. And also it is used for the individual communication, like here is the left and also here is the right. And also it can generate several sound focus, like Japanese sound and then also English sound came to the different persons. Then, so how we can make it a narrow area of the sound focus? So the point is a threshold of the self-modulation. So there is a threshold which can generate the audible sound or not audible sound. So we define this is a PTH. This is the audible sound radiation threshold. It is a self-modulation effect becomes obvious when the PU is effectively high. Its square value is not negligible. So that means ultrasonic it becomes a high intensity, it generates a sound focus, a sound, audible sound. However, under the threshold, it doesn't hear any sound. So there is a recorded sound. I recorded using the iPhone. I'm moving the phone towards the speaker like this. Yeah. Then it can generate the sound focus in the Z-axis. So can I talk a little bit about the implementation? Here is an electrical circuit design. So it have computers and also FPGA and also drivers and also the 269 channels transducers. And so how it make it focus? It generates a phase modulation of the each transducers. So the color shows each phase of the each speakers. So it generates the focus in the 150 millimeters above the device, like this. Then modulates the audible sound, like a narration or movie, not a movie, like a music. By modulating with the ultrasonic, we can generate the sound focus like that. So let me talk about the evaluation. And also this is audio distribution I evaluated with my machines, that the XY plotter and also Z plotters. And also the, in the center figure, you can see the target distribution. It is a quite narrow area to 20 millimeters by 20 meters. However, it is really difficult to collect the sound because of the interference of the mic is generated in the noise, like left figure, you can see. And also the important thing is our contribution is minimum focal area is 220 millimeter by 20 millimeter. However, the conventional sound speaker, directional speaker, makes 600 millimeters by 1,600 millimeters. It is so small area we can target in. And also the important things is this one. So this is the simulated result of the shape of the sound source. This is important because of the sound focal point, the shape changes when it's far above from the our speakers. So this is the size of the speaker decides the fundamental limitation of the beamforming. So if the speaker is bigger, that can make the precise point. However, it is smaller, it easily become to the like a beams, conventional types. So now we using the 150 millimeters radius speakers, so it can make the audible sound spots in the 50 millimeter towards 1,500 millimeters in that areas. And also, here is a user study, and we evaluated with the users who can collect the answer where is the sound spots. So the XY in the XY axis, they can correctly answer the where the sound is. However, the in the Z axis, this direction, it user can distinguish. However, some guys will mistake because of the it is really difficult to know about the height position of the sound focus. I think and also the this is a more precise about the distance, and also it makes 200 millimeter, 400 millimeter, and it is so confused with the users. So it is quite hard in the 1 meter areas to distinguish. However, it is for the Z axis. So about the XY axis, we can find which is the sound or where is the sound locations. So from this user study, we understand that make a larger difference for the Z is good for the to show the direction, or change the XY direction is suitable for the audible interactions. And also, we'd like to talk about the sound qualities. And
sound voxels, rendering audible spots in three-dimensional space by focusing carrier ultrasonic waves.
Yeah, this is the narrations. And also, this is the conventional speakers, these two audio is different because of the previous one is plana wave, and this is a focused wave at the mic point. And also look at the FFT spectrums. It is almost the same. However, in our mistake, we have some noises on the because of the condensers. And however, the other feature is almost the same of the conventional studies. And so I'd like to talk about the applications. And also the feature for the novel applications, it have an interactive sound distribution, and also the narrow and broad distribution can switchable, and also the it can be traceable, it can trace the users, and also the changing the focus, and also it can combine with the haptic and push and these kind of things. And so traditionally it used place the sound spot. However, it more precisely, and also it can be interactive with users to generate the sound focus by combining the camera or depth cameras. And also, it can be applicable to use with a can you hear? No? Is it too small? It can generate the sound in the internal of the music instruments, generating the focus. And also, this one is this voxels say something like birds. Yeah, combined with the levitations. And also, I think this is a typical use case, like place the sound spot for the pickup target, like here is the sound, or this guy. Or making the super narrow distribution for the spot, spotting captions. Like this. And also, it can be used in the, like a traffic under the traffic light, and also the training for the dogs, and also 3D manipulation in the aerial space. You know, so to summarize that, this technique is will expand the audio recognition and also audio interactions. Like this can be used with like a Siri or Google Apps or this kind of the voice recognition techniques. It can be used for the separate interaction for the audible interactions. That is quite important for the Alexa or Siri or Next interaction for the users. So for that reason, we developed these speakers. So it is also possible in the scenario, like in the car, that is only the father can hear the navigation, and children play with other sound things, and also mother hearing the shopping things. And also it can be enabled to individual audio interaction for the voice control, for the large televisions or large monitors, and also simultaneously, translation service is quite important for the use case, like I generate Japanese, English, and also together. And then, we'd like to conclude our study. So there is four discussion points, and one is the ultrasonic exposure. It is about the health problem. However, it is lower intensity than the haptic feedback, and also the direct exposure. Exposure is not necessary because of the we can generate a sound focus, so it's necessary to hit your ear directly. However, it can deliver the audible sound. And also the multiple sound points by the computer-generated holograms is available. And also amplitude of the audio signals, audio signal affects both amplitude and the audible distribution. I think this is a limitation and a trade-off. And also the grating lobes of the ultrasonic speakers is generated. So this is a second limitation and trade-off. And also the most big limitation is the size of the speaker decides the fundamental limitation of the beamforming. So if the size is limited, that is quite not work so good. And so here is a summarize of our study and also the conclusion. So thank you for listening. And here is the team. Any questions?
Yes. XJ Tao from Huawei Technologies. There are two questions from me. One is typically the ultrasound level is quite high compared to audible sound. Hmm. So have you studied the impact on the pets and your animals?
Why you? Actually, I haven't studied about the pets. However, I tested with my pet. They run away from our audible areas. Yeah, my dogs run away from my sound beams. Yeah, however, I have to check about our animals or something. Mm. And the next questions?
Second question is, you show a picture where the family members sit in the car.
Yep.
The ideal situation is that they cannot hear the different sound, but in reality, when the ultrasound hits the face, it will disperse, and probably they would hear it. Have you tried that?
Actually, that in the car we haven't tried. However, the, in the experimental conditions we tested. And so the important thing is how to generate, how to minimize the amplitude of the audible sound. So you, the point of the you pointed out is correct. That's because of the reflection of the, our face generates the different sound to the others. However, the, if it gonna be it gonna be enough to minimize the amplitude of the audible sound, it can be available.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I like your work on how to steering the sound beam. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Let's thank the speaker. Thank you.
Thank you so much.